This is on drop rate, a series where I hunt items in old school RuneScape within their stated rates according to the OSRS wiki. If I get the items within the rates, for example up to 10,000 lava dragons for a visage, I get to keep everything I earn during the grind. If I do not receive it, I have to give away half the loot to you guys, the viewers. With that, let's get into today's episode. In this episode of On Drop Rate, we are venturing into the wilderness once again to farm Larren's keys through the Wilderness Slayer. I have never really done much Wilderness Slayer, so this is going to be a pretty new experience to me, but the item we're going for is the dagon'hai hat, which is a 1 in 256 drop rate from the big Larren's chest. To get a Wilderness Slayer task, you have to go to Crystallia, located in Edgeville, and the Slayer points that you actually get from Wilderness Slayer is the best in the entire game. On top of that, the experience and money from doing this is probably the best you can also get through Slayer, so this is going to be a very fun video to make. Would you look at that? That is the first Larren's key of the entire video, and I've never got these before because I've never done Wilderness Slayer before, so it's going to be really interesting to see how long it actually takes to get 256 of them. I assume I'm going to be getting a ton of these, and you can see that just by how many of them is on the ground. I am not going to be doing any clue scrolls during this video. I do expect the grind to take a good amount of time anyways. Now, before you can get any Slayer points from the Slayer Master, as it is complete separate to the other ones, you had to complete 5 tasks, so that is now the first Slayer points of this entire grind. 25 points per task, and there's going to be a lot for the 10 and 50 and 100 ones as well. Oh, 84 Revenant? I didn't even know you could get this as a task, actually, but I am kind of unsure about this one, because I assume it's going to be a lot of PK, so I'm not sure if it's good for keys. I think that was like 2 minutes until I got attacked, maybe less than that actually. I've done 6 kills and there is already a peak here. So I think what I'm going to do, I don't think the drop rates are great for Larren's keys, and also you can't use a cannon on the Revenants. I'm just going to do Revenants sometimes when I get the task, on like the lower times when not as many people are online. I'll probably do them at that point, but otherwise I'll probably skip it. Though I can't really deny, the money is pretty good, 1.4 million from pretty much only half the task, so it is pretty tempting. Honestly, probably not going to do Hill Giants again, but it was a pretty fast task, just not great for Larren's keys, but that is now 10 tasks completed for 125 Slayer points. I'm not complaining about the points I'm getting. Now let me ask you, what is realistically the odds of these guys having a lockpick? Ro, do you have one? No, he doesn't have one. I don't think I should be in too much danger, even though it is an entire team. It is actually singles, and I think the Axis is going to keep me in combat, so even if they would have a lockpick, I would probably be fine. Yo, the first Trover Parchment, 900k, that has a good value to it. I'm probably going to get not that many of them. I think they're like 1 in 1,200, something like that from Necreal, so not super common. This is how you do Scorpia as a Slayer task. It's not really any Larren's keys, but the Slayer task is completed very quickly. You just kite Scorpia around and you have your cannon just killing all of the small scorpions. In my opinion, this is probably the best task that I can actually get. Abyssal Demons that I can cannon and barrage at the same time. The only downside to this task is that it is over 30 wilderness. So if someone attacks me and the Abyssal Demon teleports me into the deeper parts, I am probably pretty fucked. Another Trover Parchment. I see it already lost like 60k in value, so hopefully it doesn't drop too much. Oh my god, these are adorable. Look at these. Okay, their eyes look kind of psychotic, but the hats they've put, because it's Christmas, the party hat and the Santa hat at the same time, is kind of dope. And here we go, the first superior of the entire grind. Hopefully I get lucky and get a bunch of these, because in the wilderness, when you do Wilderness Slayer, that is guaranteed a Larren's key every single kill. That is not the case with, for example, Konar. Superiors on Konar tasks do not always get brimstone keys. Oh my god, another Larren's key. I said I might not do any Revenant tasks, but I might do them on Revenant Dark Beasts instead, because this is a bit more safe. I can teleport out at the line I've actually drawn on the Runelight plugin, where the guy just logged in, but that guy is not a PKer. But this clip is actually a pretty big milestone right here. We're going to be getting so many points. 50 tasks completed, 375 Slayer points. But we do not have that many keys, like 45, so I'm going to probably do over 200 tasks in this video. Oh yeah, that is why I love this task, man. It's 1 in 512 to get a 1.5 million drop. And of course, I can get the Trover Parchments from these as well. And I mean, why not? At the tail end of the same task, a second Abyssal Whip. I really don't know if I should leave right now. I mean, I'm risking like 3 million in my looting bag. If you die with stuff in your looting bag, they are always lost, but it's only 10 more to go. You have got to be kidding me. Dude, this... Dude, I can't do anything but laugh. Like, I'm 100% dead here. I have... It says zero left on the task, but I think it's like one or two because it's just tracking wrong. I don't know. I'm just going to die here. There's just no way. I don't have enough food. That is so unfortunate. Well, at least these two PKers get one whip each. I'm going to try to escape, but I have no dehydes. They have magic. Yeah, I am absolutely dead here, but yeah, that's what happens. That is a part of the wilderness, and I was just greedy. I should have teleported out, but I really did not expect to actually get... And a third one logs in, that's great. Yeah, so I did not really expect to actually get PK'd here when I only had 10 more left to go, but that is a lesson I have now learned. If I get some great drops, I should probably teleport out. And there it is. Good fight. I am going to type grats on two whips. Because they do deserve it. I do have to admit, the people that do make bots have a very vivid imagination. Warcrime 642 is an interesting name. I wonder if there's a Warcrime 641. I did look it up, by the way. This guy has only done magic, and that's it. Hoarder, what is that? Wait, I got a second pet? I already have this pet. Imagine getting two pets in 114 KC. Is that a combat task to get a duplicate pet? That is so interesting. Well, I guess I have two now. And also on top of that, this Chaos Elemental has even more surprises for us. This is task number 100 for 625 Slayer points. I wonder how many points I'm going to end up with after this grind. I might end up using a lot of them to get more barrageable tasks, but I guess we'll see. And by the way, as I said, I'm probably going to be doing over 200 tasks in this video. That is proven by having 88 keys at a 100 task point. And if I go to the bank now at 117 tasks, if I put these keys in, that is exactly 100 Larren's keys. So we have a bit more than half the grind left to do, but I'm not really bored of it yet. Oh, you have a funny feeling that you would have received a champion scroll. This is the giant one, and it is the only champion scroll that I have on the entire account. So, guess I have two of them now. It has actually been a pretty long time because it's been pretty uneventful. I haven't really got anything super rare or anything like that. I am at 167 keys right now, and I'm just going to give you guys a brief update of the overall Slayer loot that I've got so far. This right here says almost 60 million GP. And if I go through some of these, you can see some of the loot that I've got. Mammoths is pretty nice. Abyssal Demons got two whips that I got PK'd for, which was not that good. Lesser Demon, 1.7k of them. Greater Demon, 1.4k. Yeah, I've killed a lot of enemies. And if we can actually find Necreol, look at that. 13.6 million GP only from Necreols is pretty insane. I had a bunch of extra points and I still have 1.5k, spent 300 on extending Necreols, Abyssal Demons, and Dust Devils, pretty much all the barrageable tasks in the wilderness. I probably should have done this earlier because they are incredibly good tasks for Larren keys. They all have superiors and they are very fast to kill, and every superior is guaranteed a Larren's key, so hopefully I will get a lot of those tasks in the future. And that is the exact reason why I wanted to extend 226 Abyssal Demons. That is ridiculous. I think pretty much every single other task has been like 110. So that is pretty much doubling all my bursting tasks. Okay, this is not live commentary, but I do have to show you guys this. Every single time two people attack me, I am usually doomed because one guy can run ahead a bit and just keep rooting me the entire time, and I have to live for 5 minutes because of the teleblock. But these guys did not do that, and they splashed a lot. Like, I screwed up here so hard, I don't know what I was doing. They both splashed those entangles, and on top of that, they splashed like four times before that. And then I was like, oh, maybe I can actually gap them here, and I ended up actually gapping them. I think overall, for them to actually not get this kill, I think they splashed like eight entangles in a row on me, which is ridiculous. So we just finished a greater demon task and we got four keys from that one. Actually very lucky, and I've done 195 tasks overall, but that is now over 200 keys in the bank. We're getting really close to done with the entire grind, which I am very happy about, because being on alert all the time in the wilderness, watching for PKs and all that is not super fun in my opinion, but hopefully we're done soon. Also, if you are curious, I'm about 70 hours into the grind so far, so most likely this is going to be the longest grind I've done so far. Yes, let's go! That is the last Larren's key of the entire grind. That took a very long time. We ended on 220 Slayer tasks, but let's go to a bank and chuck that in. And here we go. Let's go to the main tab, put those in, and now we have 256 keys to open. All in all, I killed nearly 18,000 creatures on Slayer task, and the overall GP value of that is 93 million GP, so that is quite a lot, and all of that is going to be counted into the potential giveaway if we do not get the dagon'hai hat from all of these keys. Now, when it comes to opening the Larren's chest itself, it is really risky and I do not want to die at all. So what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be bringing this setup right here, which is extremely tanky with a Din's Bulwark, and this inventory right here. It actually allows me to bring so many Sarah Brews, Restores, and Food because I can use the looting bag as it is in the wilderness. I will only bring 50 keys, and if I die with even 50 keys or 20 keys, that is a massive setback. Of course, I've never opened Larren's keys before, so I have none of the dagon'hai items on my collection log, so getting any of them is of course a massive win, on top of them being worth quite a lot of money. Let's go ahead and open and see what we can get from the first 50. Oh, there we go. So early. How many keys? Like 39 keys? For the first piece, I am definitely running to the bank now. That is one of the better ones as well. The hat is the least expensive. The top is the most expensive. The bottom is the middle one. Almost 3 million GP. And of course, a collection log slot. Oh my god. Oh my... So early into the grind, we already got the item we were hunting for. Let's go! The dagon'hai hat has been obtained. It's only 873k. But that is actually a lot more worth for me, because that means I am keeping everything that I earned during this video, including all the loot that I'm going to be getting from these Larren's keys. But that is insane. I am going to be making so much money this video. Oh my, what? Another bottom? Dude, I am getting absolutely spooned here. I just barely got back. That is insane. Okay, after that, we have 146 keys left. And this is the loot so far. 110 keys opened. No PKs yet, which I'm very happy about. But we have already made 20 million GP. That is insane. Maybe the first inventory of 50 keys that I do not get any unique in at all, but the money is always really good regardless, so I am not disappointed at all. I have already been extremely lucky, but would be really nice to see that top now. No, another dagon'hai hat. I mean, it's 873k, so it's good money, but yeah, not the piece that I want at this point. Ooh, another dagon'hai bottoms, and I wonder how much the looting bag is actually worth right now with that. 6 million GP. Yeah, you know what? I'm not opening these 22 last keys. I need to bank this. I'm not risking 6 million in the looting bag. So right now, we only have 55 keys left to go, and I have not got the top yet, as you guys have seen, and I would love to have that on the collection log. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to bring all of them. I haven't seen a PK yet. Maybe this is really dumb, but hopefully I can get the top and not actually get PK'd. I guess we are not done yet with dagon'hai pieces. We only have 10 more keys to go. We get a bottom, no top yet, and another hat. Are you kidding me, dude? I've got like 3 hats and 4 bottoms at this point, but no tops, and they're all the same drop rate, by the way, so I should really on drop rate, I should have only got 1 of each piece, but with the luck I'm having right now, I would have loved to see one of the items be a top, but I guess RNG is what it is, but the looting bag is going to be absolutely massive from this, so I am kind of scared that I'm going to get PK'd. I have seen no PK so far, as I said, so... it shouldn't be that bad, but let's actually put everything into the looting bag and see how much this looting bag is worth. The last one, if I can just click correctly, put the dragon arrows in and then the diamonds. And the overall loot of this looting bag that I'm risking right now is 10 million GP green cash, like risking in the wilderness. Max kills, don't kill me. But I guess this is the end of the Larenski chest opening, and that was a very successful opening, I would say. We definitely got pretty lucky with the dagon'hai pieces, but unfortunately we did not complete the collection log, meaning in the future sometime I will have to go back and get even more Larenski. So maybe at that point I will buy them to get the dagon'hai robe top, which unfortunately is also the most expensive one out of the bunch, and we got 4 bottoms and 3 hats. And this is the loot, 45 million GP from 256 Larren's chest. But that is going to do it for this video. If you liked the video, leave a like. Also, subscribe if you want to be notified when I post new videos. Only 30% of you guys are actually subscribed, so please do that to support the channel. But also, next episode is going to be a pet episode, episode number 40. So look forward to that. It's going to be a pretty good one. And I will see you guys in the next one. Take care. Last episode, we had a 32.6 million GP giveaway, by the way, and the winner of that is The Attrick, who says, it was raining dragon picks for a bit there. And here we have the trade of the 32.6 million GP. I hope you enjoy that, and thank you for the support on the series.